Well, welcome everybody to the Chengdu World University Games. We're here for the fencing competition in the Pidu Sports Center Gymnasium. And we're here for the men's saber and women's épée competitions. And the first of the women's épée semifinals will be between Catherine Nixon of the USA, representing Princeton University, and Shi Kaelin of Hong Kong, representing Notre Dame University in the USA. So here we go, 2 minutes left on the clock. 2 minutes for Nixon to try and level the scores. 15 the target for Shi. And Nixon's just closing the distance without any real intent to attack. And when Nixon does attack, she was able to double out. So two more points required for Shi. Great example of when you get the lead in épée. It's you're in a much better position. Attack to the foot there from Nixon missed, and she able to pick her off, and that's that. And Shi Kaelin, the 22-year-old from Hong Kong, is through to the gold medal match. So confirmation of that result, and you see how all those points came thick and fast in the third period. Shi wins that one 15-8. So the second of these semi-finals, we've got the Japanese Terayama and Sara Maria Kowalczyk of Italy. The third period gets underway. Terayama 9-6 over Kowalczyk of Italy. And Terayama knows that the ball is very much in Kowalczyk's court. It's her responsibility to try and press now. Terayama just holding her finger up there, acknowledging that she hadn't got hold of the blade like she wanted to do in that attack. And Kowalczyk was able to come through with a hit. And again, similar thing for Terayama. She's gifting these points to Kowalczyk. She doesn't need to be doing this. Well, that time she thought she'd hit. She'd have been better off just keeping that 3-point lead and running the clock down. Now, there's only 1 point in it. Easier said than done, though. If you're naturally aggressive like Terayama, to control that urge, and Kowalczyk has done a really good job of leveling the scores. So 9 apiece. And Kowalczyk using her extra reach there, and the footwork so much better from the Italian now in this third period. The control of distance better. She's not attacking from so far out. Like when she went through that period of shipping hits. Turned it completely around. So 13-12, the score, 18 seconds left on the clock. Teriyama really needs to do something now. Japanese fencer goes for it. And Kowalczyk has pretty much won this. 9 seconds left on the clock, 2-point lead. Kowalczyk is going to go through for the gold medal here. And another double sees us through to 15-12. Well, Teriyama did really good work in the beginning half of that match. But then at the beginning of the third period, it was the Italian, Sara Maria Kowalczyk, who was able to gain the lead and then go on to take the win. So a bronze medal for the Japanese fencer, Teriyama. And confirmation that it is Italy with Kowalczyk that will go through and will fight against Shi Keilin of Hong Kong for the gold medal. And the first gold medal bout in the women's épée will be between Shi Keilin of Hong Kong and Sara Maria Kowalczyk of Italy. It's a strong beat again, missed it that time. Big beats from Shi, and it worked. Well, got double scored, but Shi hitting to the chest of the Italian, and the Italian hitting the Hong Kong fencer on the leg. But the moral victory in that point was very much Shi's, because this the beat defense is working so well for her. And again, well, that time was a lovely circular disengage from Shi. Kowalczyk's devoid of ideas, needs to come find some kind of inspiration here. Double. It's been a while since Kowalczyk scored a single light. So Kowalczyk presses, Shi defends, using this beat. And then sometimes not beating, disengaging the blade. And it's one-way traffic now. Maybe Kowalczyk could try and, oh, again, a whack on the back of the hand that we've already had the doctor out for. Again, she's just walking into distance with no intention of trying to finish. And if she does finish, then it's a double. be better to try and lure that counter-attack from Shi, but anticipate it and get back out of the way. Well, there's a reason why Shi did so well at the World Championships. The fencer from Hong Kong, 16th place in Milan, and I think she was beaten was it the eventual winner? No, she lost to her teammate. She lost to Kong, Vivian Kong. Well, we're just ticking the clock down now, aren't we? Kowalczyk has run out of ideas. And you saw it with the body language at the break. She wasn't looking at her coach. Coach was like trying to tell her what to do, but then when she stepped out onto the piste for this third period, looked like she conceded the match already. I mean, but hats off to Shi. She is a brilliant fencer and one to watch in the future. And having Vivian Manwai Kong as her teammate is going to help a lot. And look at that. Well, flourish. Lovely flourish to end there. And a different class. Shi Kailin Sinyang of Hong Kong, China, takes the gold. And confirmation that Shi is in a different class. And Kowalczyk making a swift exit stage left. But the score sits at 15-10, and it was a demolishment in the third period of the Italian fencer. Well, congratulations to our medalists. And Shi of Hong Kong takes the gold. Kowalczyk of Italy takes the silver. And Nixon and Terayama of Japan take the bronze. So time now for the first semi-final. And it's a match-up between Horvath of Hungary and Gary of France. Gary trying to get out of the way, but just tickled with the blade of Horvath. It's a 4-point lead now to Hungary. Oh! Well, the first attack failed, and then Gary was unable to then score on the riposte. So it's a great display from the Hungarian, and superb, absolutely superb. So confirmation, 15-8, good win there for Gergo Horvath. He will progress through to the gold medal match. So the men's semi-final, the second of the semi-finals, against Yoshida on the left of your screen and Park on the right. It's Japan versus Korea. And now Yoshida is two away from booking a place in the gold medal match. That time, Yoshida was invited forward, but Park able to take the point. Now only 1 point in it. This is where it really starts to hot up. Park going forward quickly, then stopping. Now has the right of way. Can he finish? Yes, he can. No more videos for either of the fencers. Yoshida conceding. There was no parry. That's what they were talking about. That's what Yoshida was asking. Was there a parry there? 13 apiece. 15 to win. Yoshida went to look for the blade and couldn't find the parry. So it is now Park that is 1 point away for booking a place in the gold medal match for Korea. And for me, that was an attack from the Korean. The referee will have a look at the video. But I think that it's going to be Park Sang-won that will go through to the gold medal match. What will the referee say? Yes, confirms his decision. And in a very exciting and enthralling second semi-final, that at one stage Yoshida Tamon looked to be in control of, Park Sang-won wrestling his way back into that and is declared the winner and go through to the gold medal match. So the Hungarian Hovar up against Park Sang-won. It's going to stand. Yeah, the Hungarian just starting the attack sooner with those stuttering steps and kept moving forward. So no video reviews left for Park. The Hungarian has two and has a 4 point lead. First attack from Hovart was no, it had fallen short. So Park picks up the right of way and picks up the point. The gap now just three. Ooh, now we're going to get a yellow card here. I think we are. And Park for not starting. Now. Yeah, so the referee's calling this as simultaneous. They both came in, they started, stopped, and then they picked up again. Well, he went to the video review and he changed it back the other way. So that was the worst outcome for Horvath. And now Park is just 1 point behind. There was preparation from Horvath there. Park was much more committed to the attack. That stop there on the right from the Hungarian was enough to turn the right of way over. So it's 10 apiece, 15 the target. Horvat's got the right of way. He just keeps moving forward, keeps moving forward. Attack, no. Missed. And Park with a counter attack gets the point. It's level pegging. This is going to be a real exciting end to this men's sabre gold medal match. Park committed to the attack there, coming in from the low line. And no parry found from Horvath. Attacked from the Hungarian, attacked into a closed line there, attacked into the guard of the Korean. So effectively turned over the right of way. And now Park is the one in the box seat. Horvath closing the gap to just 1 point. Ooh, well, the referee wasn't asked to go and look, but has gone of his own volition and has given it to the Korean. Which brings the score to 14-12. And Park St. John has done it. 15-12. A great comeback there for the Korean and has won the gold. Well, it was nip and tuck all the way through that match. But Park just making absolutely sure at the end. And Gerger Horvath will settle for silver. It was a really entertaining match. 10-4 in that second half was the difference. And Park Sang-won was able to win 15-12. So confirmation that Korea take the gold with Park. Horvath the silver for Hungary. Gary and Yoshida for France and Japan take the bronze.